better run for the hills. She'll try any ruse till she gets your autograph. If you refuse, it could be your epitaph. You give her the chill, she's Pepper Mills. Pepper.
Place, Boston Harbor. The date, December 16, 1773.
And so the British Parliament passed the Stamp Act, which taxed newspapers, playing cards, and all printed material imported by the colonies. The American colonists were not happy.
But the rest of Europe was not happy.
We're not happy.
The place, Woolsthorpe, England, home to the single greatest scientific mind in the history of the human race. This mathematical genius is about to make a discovery that will forever change the course of history.
I'll give the general some helpful information. My enlistment's up in 10 days, and I'm counting the minutes.
This man is a notorious turncoat. I want to interrogate him personally in my tent.
I say, what's all this then? I signed on to fight for liberty. I'm sorry I ever heard the word. It's cold, and I ain't got nothing for my feet. I went 4 days without food. Till I caught me a possum. Ever eat possum? I never will again.
Why, how terribly British of you.
Yes, don't we all?
Now, as you may have surmised, I am British.
Remember me? You were asking me those questions last night? I'm soon to be ex-private Edward Hughes of Virginia, by the way.
I am ready.
Patience, Joubert. As dear as I hold you, you must prove yourself in the field before I can give you men to command.
Forgive me, General, but then how may I serve our cause?
My friend, I am certain opportunities will present themselves.
To the core, I'm afraid.
Quite all right.
And as a British subject, I must admit I'm awfully fond of tea. And at this very moment, my palate is parched to the extreme.
Your point, sir?
My point is that I would very much enjoy a bit of tea.
Oh, you would?
Sans doute, I should say so in a nutshell, yes.
Well, you come to the right place, huh? We're having a tea party, you know.
So I've heard. My thirst mounts by the nanosecond.
Righto then, what'll it be? We have the widest selection of teas in all the colony, sir.
Splendid. I think a pot of chamomile for this time of night.
Coming right up, sir.
Don't touch. I'll take this one.
Just thought I'd have a few of my friends over for a little slumber party in your room. I guess I overbooked it. Hey, no hard feelings. You don't mind, do you? Everybody got their checkbooks?
Yeah!
This is a tea party, isn't it?
But of course not, Abe. But it is for rent. Hey, y'all. I'll rustle up some grub. Now, who wants fries?
I want one!
There you go, kiddo.
Thank you, sir!
And finally, I sneaked out wearing a wig and a dress.
Its success will depend upon our ability to meet that challenge and time the landings so that the Hessians will be surprised before they are out of their beds.
I ain't seen none of it so far. All's we've done is retreat and retreat again. This is the most useless mess I ever got involved in. Out of dessert.
Then give me some!
We're finished, Sam. Let's go. Oh, sorry, sir. We're closed. Party's over. Gotta run. Cheerio. Bye-bye.
But on Pepper's Pep Rally, he's decided to secretly switch sides and help the British win the war. Not only would he get his revenge, he would also get to be a respected British general.
I like it. Thanks. I did it. I figured out the force that makes the moon go around the earth, the stars stay in the sky, and apples fall to the ground. My goodness, I've got to go tell the world. I'm going to tell them that I have discovered gravity.
And now here's the start of our show, Pepper Mills.
Hi, gang. Welcome to my extremely cool show where I get to meet people that are worth meeting. Today, my guest is the king of gangster rap. Please welcome Coolio. Funny. You look a lot different in person, Coolio. Maybe if you went back to your old hairstyle.
Now, I suppose you're wondering why I called you all here.
It looks so, you're not Coolio, are you?
Besides that.
Well, it was worth a shot. Oh, I see. Calvin Coolidge, 30th U.S. President. You're Coolidge!
Excellent. If you succeed, your bravery will be remembered in a cartoon on TV. If you don't, we'll always remember you.
Okay, can I have your autograph? Oh, thank you. Oh, you don't know how much this means to me.
course, the Redcoats are led by veteran General Charles Cornwallis. And recently, the British picked up a free agent from the American side.
Where burglars were caught breaking into the offices of the Democratic National Committee. It was an election year, and they were trying to steal files about the Democrats' election strategy.
Mr. Socrates, no. Hi, I'm Lydia Karaoke, network censor. I'm sorry, even though this is the WB, we do have standards, and we're having a little problem with the fact that you're a violent criminal hosting a kiddies' television show. Especially now that you're sending one of the youngins to fetch a six-shooter in yonder barn.
Really? Chipola!
The battles between the colonists and King George of England were totally outnumbered, but the rest of Europe was exposed.
Gentlemen! Prepare to get beat up! Get him!
Lowlife!
Bum! Heathen!
That's it! I've... Gravity.
Look! It's Abby Hoffman! Get him!
Charge! Let's get him!
And after that, let's go to Disneyland.
I say, after him! Don't let them...